Welcome to my channel. If you like my videos, then kindly subscribe, like and watch. Thank you.
Welcome back. Problem 7.8. The state of stress is shown in this figure, so you have to determine the principal plane and principal stresses. So let's start. So given data from the state of stress, you can write given data sigma x is equal to 18 ksi because it is in x direction, and sigma y is equal to minus 12 ksi because it is in compression. So that is minus 12 ksi, and tau of xy is, now you can understand this is 18 ksi because this face is perpendicular to the axis in positive direction, and the shear stress is also in upward y direction. So this is 8 ksi. So let me correct it. So this is 8 ksi. Clear? Okay. So what we have to find is again principal planes, and B part is principal stresses, that is sigma max and sigma minimum. Now you must be able to know that principal plane is theta p1 and theta p2. Clear? So that's why I just write theta p. So let's start with its solution. Again, you know for part A, we know that tangent, we will use this formula, tangent of 2 theta p is equal to 2 tau of xy divided by sigma x minus sigma y. So you have to put the value, so 2 into 8 divided by sigma x is equal to 18, which is given over here. So 18 minus, and this sigma y is minus 12. Clear? So this will be equal to 16 divided by 18 plus 12. So tangent of 2 theta p is equal to 16 divided by 30. Clear? And this is equal to 0.533. So 2 theta p will be equal to tan inverse 0.533, and this 2 theta p, when you take the tan inverse of this value, so this 2 theta p is 28.07 degree. So again, theta p1 will be equal to 28.07 divided by 2, which is approximately equal to 14 degree, and theta p2 can be obtained if you add 90 degree with this theta p1. So theta p2 is equal to theta p1 plus 90 degree. So again, this is equal to 14 plus 90, which is equal to 104 degrees. So this is theta p2, and theta p1 is equal to 14 degree only. So these are the principal planes. Clear? Now we will move toward our part B, which is equal to sigma max comma sigma minimum. That is equal to sigma x plus sigma y divided by 2 plus minus under the root sigma x minus sigma y divided by 2 whole square plus tau of xy whole square. So the repetition is also very good because you will be able to memorize it easily. So sigma max minus sigma minimum, sigma x is again, sigma x is 18, so 18 plus, and this is minus, so plus minus minus, minus 12 divided by 2 plus minus, this is sigma x is 18 minus and minus 12 plus 12, divided by 2 whole square plus 8 whole square. Again, this sigma max comma minimum will be equal to 18 minus 12, which is equal to 6. 6 divided by 2 is equal to 3. So 3 plus minus under the root, this will be 30 divided by 2 is equal to 15 whole square plus 8 whole square. Let me clear it. 8 whole square. And this will be equal to plus 3 plus minus. And when you calculate this whole term, so it will give you 17. So it means that sigma max is equal to 3 plus 17, which is equal to 20 KSI. Clear? And sigma minimum will be equal to 3 minus 17, which is equal to minus 14 KSI. So these are the principal stresses that is acting on this principal plane. So if I draw it, so let this is your initial axis, x-axis. Let me draw it clearly. So this is horizontal axis x and this is y. Now if you are going to represent them, so theta is 14 degrees, so you will definitely from this x-axis you will draw a line that is 14 degree. So let this is your 14 degree. Okay? And the second line that is also the angle between these them is also 14 degree. So this will be y dash. Now your element will be like that. Clear? So you will represent the stresses. So this will be your this force will be perpendicular to this face, clear? So when you will draw, you will take care of that. So this is sigma max and this sigma max is 20 KSI. Here similarly your sigma y I will show over here, that is minus 14, and so it will be in compression. So you have to represent them like that. You have to draw it in mid. But in order to not mess up with this line, I have drawn over here. So this is sigma minimum and this sigma minimum is equal to minus 14 KSI. Again, this total angle is 104 degree because this is 90, clear? And this is 14, so total is 104. This is theta p2. This is, and this is theta p1. So this was all about problem 7.8. I hope you have enjoyed the video. Thank you and keep watching for learning more and more.